Roy Wilkins, Samuel Yeun. First in myth, later in reality, passion and violence watered my root soil. My name is Roy Ottaway Wilkins. I was born on August 30, 1901 in St. Louis, Missouri. My father was not present for my birth as he refused to step away and yield the sidewalk for a white man and was afraid of being lynched. He fled town and I never saw him again. When I was 4 years old, my mother died from tuberculosis, after which I was taken care of by my caring aunt and uncle. I graduated from the University of Minnesota with a degree in sociology in 1923. In 1929, I met my beautiful wife, Aminda Badau. I called her Minnie, though. Unfortunately, we were unable to conceive a child of our own. I was particularly interested in the civil rights movement and devoted all my time into it. In 1950, my hard work came to fruition as I founded the Leadership Conference on Civil Rights along with my colleagues Philip Randolph and Arnold Aronson. LCCR has coordinated the national legislative campaign on behalf of every major civil rights law since 1957. In 1955, I was given the title of Executive Secretary, which was later changed to Executive Director in 1964, of the NAACP. I supported civil rights activists who were being denied loans through a credit squeeze by white banks. Along with my good friend Dr. T.D.M. Howard Wilkins, I proposed that black businesses and voluntary associations shift their accounts to the black-owned tri-state of Memphis. Through this, $280,000 was deposited in Tri-State by the end of 1955. One of my most notable accomplishments was participating in the March on Washington in 1963, where I gave my speech on civil rights and the truth of freedom of all. Although I was part of protesting and marching, I was strictly nonviolent as a militant-like Black Power movement caused too much trouble and tension. I was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by Lyndon Johnson. I retired in 1977 at the age of 76. During the March on Washington, I gave a speech where I attempted to acquire equal access to jobs for African Americans and asked for a Fair Employment Practice Committee bill, also known as an FEPC bill, as a part of the legislative package. I had a philosophy for a colorblind America and attempted to sway the white man during my speech. I said that rules are made to enable a Congress to legislate and not to keep it from legislating.
Thank you, Mr. Randolph. First of all, I want to thank all of you for coming here today because you saved me from being a liar. I told them you would be here. They didn't believe me because you always make up your mind at the last minute. And you had me scared. But isn't it a great day? Yeah.